Joining us via Skype from Dutse, the Jigawa State capital, is the Deputy Governor of Jigawa State, Alhaji Ibrahim Hassan. Thank you so much for coming on the program. Families have been rendered homeless since the unfortunate incident, and they are calling on your government to help them find decent places to live in. What steps has the government taken to address this call?
I think we took a step barely 24 hours after this incident happened by immediately getting the State Emergency Management Agency to respond with food items and mattresses and bedding. That was what we could immediately do in the situation. As I'm talking to you now, we finished doing an assessment of those that were directly affected. There were 55 houses, actually, not 50, with about 106 adults. And when this thing happens, when things like this happen, we usually try to keep them to help them get back on their feet. So I think by tomorrow, there will be an exercise where all these 106 adults will get a stipend. And this is outside building materials, mattresses, bedding, and food items that we gave them a day after the incident.
Now, how about plans to help them find new means of livelihood? Because from our report, you know, livestock destroyed, silos, grains destroyed. What are you doing to help them find their footing?
This is what the monetary supplement is all about. We do an assessment. Every household, we look at the number of adults that stay in that household. And these are what we enumerated, totaling 106. They're all getting some kind of monetary stipend. When these things happen, we can't compensate everyone 100%. But you know, just to try to get them back to their feet. It's quite minor as these things go by. There was no life lost. So typically around this time, it's been 9 months or so since the last rainfall. Everything is bone dry. We do try to sensitize people to be careful about open fires, especially in the smaller villages where you have thatch roofs, because once one catches fire, invariably before you can put it out, it spreads and takes everything along with it. That's what the stipend is about, just to help them get by and put the incident behind them.
Now let's talk about the response level of the emergency team. Reports have it that, you know, it was quite slow, wasn't prompt. How did that happen? What happened?
The same IBG responded within 24 hours. A day after this incident, they were there with food items, with mattresses, and with bedding. And in fact, most of the people in that, a lot of Good Samaritans also responded. So we had to set up a small committee headed by the village head and the councillor, whose ward the village is in, to try and coordinate most of these nations. So we actually have, you know, I know the senator representing that area has donated some money on foodstuff. Some of the prominent people from the village have all responded. So we try to coordinate all this so that they can complement what the state government has done. But we responded within 24 hours, you know, as an emergency response. And by tomorrow, what we have been doing over the last week or so is do the enumeration, find out how many adults are in each household, and try to see if we could give them some cash so that they could continue with their lives. But the response was within 24 hours.
Have you been able to ascertain the cause of the fire?
It was accidental, as far as we know. It started, I think, from the market. Maybe somebody who was selling foodstuff left her cooking materials, and it spread. Like I told you, everything is bone dry around this time of the year. It's very hot. There hasn't been a single raindrop in 9 months. And once a fire starts off like this, you know, it goes completely out of control. They are not within range of fire service. It's a very small village, quite a bit of a distance from the local government capital. So before they could respond, you know, the fire had done its damage, but it was accidental.
Now, I do know that you've told me plans your government is making to get their homes back, but what is the makeshift arrangement for those who say they're forced to sleep on the streets?
No, they are not. They're all the public buildings in that vicinity have been given out for them to use. All the schools have been shut down temporarily. Most of the government warehouses have also been given for them to move in before they rebuild their houses. As I talk to you, there's a lot of rebuilding going on. The government has given them some building materials. Like I said, some Good Samaritans have contributed various items, and that's being coordinated so that it can be distributed equally among the 55 households that were affected. So they're not living in the they're not living outdoors or anything like that, contrary to what is being said out there. They're being properly housed. I think a few of them have actually gotten to see where they moved back to their houses. The damage we're talking about is to the roof. Most of them are thatched roofs, and they burn down to the ground very quickly. But most of the physical structures are still there. All you need to do is pick them up, put a new roof, and you can move back to your house.
Now, where exactly are they staying? I do know that you said public facilities have been made available. Where is this?
The primary school in that village is under use. There's a fertilizer warehouse that is presently empty. We've also directed that they can move the women and children there temporarily. And like I said, the rebuilding is going on as we speak.
Thank you very much, Deputy Governor of Jigawa State, Laji Ibrahim Hassan. Thank you so much for joining us on News Across Nigeria.